वेलकम डियर लर्नर मॉर्निंग लेक्चर माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर प्रोफेसर इमानुएल कुमार डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश बीन कुली बढ़िया टुडे वी विल डिस्कस साइकोलॉजिकल नॉवल आफ्टर फिनिशिंग इजम ग्रुप एंड ब्रिटिश हिस्ट्री ऑफ लिटरेचर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल इज आई कवर इट सो टुडे आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिस्कस अबाउट फिक्शन मॉडल वेरी रिलेवेंट टॉपिक साइकोलॉजिकल नॉवल Indirectly, it can be said a stream of consciousness. Now, welcome back. Coming to the point, the factual aspect of psychological novel, what it means, what is concept behind it, what is the writer approach towards psychological novel or stream of consciousness. So at first I will define novel. Psychological novel means the inner quality, the inner experience of mind. Despite this, as we know, as English student, dear learner, that novel presents complete picture of life. This is novel. But there are types of novel. Perhaps you know Gothic novel, psychological novel. Ordinary novels as written by Dickens and Charles, Jane Austen, Hard Times, Pride and Prejudice, etc. So general novel presents complete picture of life. But Gothic novel is different. Psychological novel is different. So coming to the point, I would like to focus you what happens in psychological novel. What you are thinking at that time in present in your mind, what goings to be happen, what you are thinking at that moment, you present through character. This is this stream of consciousness, and this is psychological novel in the 21st century and 21st century, the modern era, which covers the American phenomenon. That is the psychological novel, the concept of the focal and central point of psychological novel. Your thought present at that moment in mind, what you are thinking and framing, what you are making, you present it through character, through persona, through protagonist. That is the concept of psychological novel in the 20th century era of British history literature. Welcome back, dear learner, English student. At first, psychological novel written by Leo Tolstoy, a Russian thinker and novelist. Crime and Punishment, War and Peace. This was the first novel, psychological novel, published in 1835. Crime and Punishment, War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy. What he presents Leo Tolstoy in this novel? We find there is a data humanism, data religion, orientation, communication, alienation, ordinary humanism. No. Humanism means glorification of man. Data humanism presents the digital world, the present world, the digital world, electronics world. That is data religion, data humanism. Leo Tolstoy was trying to focus in this novel through character the present point, the present thinking of mind, because you know thinking is a mental process, purely mental process is thinking. It depends upon your capability of intellectual scholastic quality, intellectual hub, scholastic hub, how far you have bombasting, like how do you think? What is difference between your thinking and a rickshaw puller and a general man, a Dalit thinking, who has not taken education, a higher education or an English man? What is their thinking? It depends upon your language. Man think through language. As far you have bombasting language, your thinking will be differ from ordinary people, on the road sharp people. That is difference. Reading Ovid, reading Petrarch, you are an English man. So dear learner, I would like to focus you psychological novel. The level of thinking, the level of vision, which I would like to focus you. A writer, scientist, philosopher have a secondary vision. Rare politicians have secondary vision who frame policy, domestic or foreign policy. That is rare we find in foreign politician. But this is psychological novel I am giving lecture on psychological novel, which I would like to focus you, the inner quality, the mind in which you are happening, is going to be happen, what you are thinking. That is psychological novel. As you know, two type of quality, unification of sensibility and dissociation of sensibility. Unification of sensibility produces good things, whereas dissociation of sensibility produces bad things. The writer of Stream of Consciousness, psychologist, have unification of sensibility, not dissociation of sensibility. Of course, without hesitation, we can say almost all foreign writers, American, French, Italian, Scandinavian, German, they have secondary vision, they have unification of sensibility, they have a rich quality English potentiality, not like Indian writers like R.K. Narayan, Murukrajanan, Anita Desai. They have lesser sensibility, they have lesser quality, they are wisest but meanest. They have virtuous fool, having no secondary vision, no English sensibility. Welcome back, dear learner. The another part of psychological novel is a stream of consciousness. What happens you see in a stream of consciousness? In the first part of the 20th century, the art of fiction went considerably change. Psychology discovered that life is a flux and the mind of man is an extremely complex phenomenon. Everything is drowned in the stream of consciousness, only consciousness remains. That is the paradigm, paramount of a stream of consciousness. Consider this powerful power of experience of the writer like James Joyce, Ulysses, a very wonderful creation, Virginia Woolf, Dorothy Richardson, they all agree on this view. So dear learner, this psychological novel, this stream of consciousness is a part of psychological novel, which I have focused you, which I am teaching you. I am giving a lecture very compact, a very scrutinized press lecture I am giving you, presenting you in front of an English learner, English man, English professor teaching you, the psychologist, psychological novel, the inner reality, the inner thought, which you present through persona, character, that is psychological novel. And James Joyce, Ulysses, and Virginia Woolf is a wonderful creation of the stream of consciousness and psychological novel. Leo Tolstoy, as we have discussed, the crime and punishment, war and peace. Dear learner, we are talking about sensibility and vision. An English writer and an Indian writer. Of course, in India there are 20 English writers, perhaps as I think. But what is the remark of foreign writers, British American writers, is this: they have lesser English sensibility, not rich English potentiality as Shakespeare, Milton, Bernard Shaw, Eliot, Percy Bysshe Shelley, William Walter Yeats has. Literature cannot be still. Literature, English literature, heightens the awareness of human life. Language is a living thing. English language is a living thing. With the change in social setup, automatically there is a change in the use of language. Dear learner, I would like to speak a French word, sanguin, E-N-N-U-I. That means relation, blood relation. Shakespeare said, near to blood, nearer blood. I am using this French word because you are an English student, English learner. You must read Scandinavian, Italian, French, American, German, etc. languages. So, British literature, impact of dystopia and impact of contemporary trends, as we have discussed, data religion, data humanism, orientation, alienation, communication, and psychological novel, the impact on British literature, that in one party, psychological novel, another party, the stream of consciousness, which we discussed. So, I suggest you that you learn more. You must benefit from my lecture. You come prepared. Try to understand, try to digest my lecture, because sometimes I use very bombasting and foreign languages, foreign words, because you are a student of English. You have appetite for English. You have opted the subject. That's why you have appetite to know more about English literature and do better in the future for English language and in the destiny of your country. Destiny of country. You may be Shakespeare Milton, why not? Nothing is impossible. Impossible in the world is written in the study of fools. When you will be touches world literature, the English British literature, the concept of dystopia, impact of contemporary writer on British literature, impact of psychological novel, a stream of consciousness on British literature, when it becomes clear your concept that you are really an English gentleman on this earth. Dear learner, welcome back. That is the last point of a psychological novel. I have given example of Leo Tolstoy, Virginia Woolf, James Joyce. They are wonderful creator of psychological novel and psychologist. A thinker and psychology writer, English writer and psychologist. That's why they produces this theme, the novel, which he has introduced through character. You remember in mind only these things. I have given a very complex lecture on the stream of consciousness. But in psychological novel, when this matter comes, when these things comes, you must think that in psychological novel, what you are thinking at that point, at that moment, what happens in your mind, what concept takes place, you narrate, narrative style, you narrate these things through character, through persona, through protagonist, your concept, your thought, your present thinking. This is the focal central point of psychological novel. That is the jaw of psychological novel, that is the theme and screw and press of a psychological novel, which I have discussed you in details. I hope that my lecture never goes in vain and your labor never goes in vain. This is immortal. How a man can be great when his personal thought becomes universal, touches the worldly life. It becomes to happen everybody, touches the heart. That is the greatness of a writer, not only writer, of anybody else. That is the greatness of thought. So, dear learner, this psychological novel I have elaborated, examined from all language, touches from Russian Leo Tolstoy to Virginia Woolf and James Joyce, 20th century modern writer, the stream of consciousness, psychological novel. I have examined from all angles, chop it into words, into phrases, the catching phrases of this stream of consciousness, the psychological novel. So I hope you understand my point, my vision, my thought, my sensibility. Receive your mind as an English gentleman, English man, English student. So I hope that you read more. You must purchase a book of Kazamia, History of English Literature, British History, Social History, how the writer came, in which ages, and what was the position of England at that time, social, economical, political position of England, how writer flourished during this period, what are the kings, the Badshah of England, vision, doctrine at that time given full freedom to writer, that's why the age flourished, succeeded. This is the main thing of British history, the English literature, English language. So I repeat it again and again, I repeat you that you must have a broad concept about history of British English literature, about fiction, drama, prose, novel, everything, etc. So I have finished my lecture at that point. Have a nice day. Long life, comma. Long life tolerance. Long life innocent. Thank you, with good wishes always.